Today we're going to be talking about safety essentials and what we believe are the top safety essentials when traveling with an RV. This is going to be broken down into two parts. I'm going to be talking about safety when traveling on the road.
And I will be talking about safety at the campsite.
Let's get to it. When it comes to safety equipment when towing, the first thing I think about is a tire pressure monitoring system. I've learned from experience that not having a tire pressure monitoring system can be dangerous and can cause a lot of damage to your travel trailer and even your truck. We have a TireMinder solar powered trailer, TPMS. As we have four tires on our trailer, it comes with four sensors. They just screw onto the valve stems of each tire. There's a signal booster that attaches to the front of the trailer near the battery and clamps onto the battery for power. And then there is the readout unit that you stick in your windshield. The back of it is a solar panel, so you don't even need to wire it in. The system will tell you the tire pressure of each tire as well as the temperature. And it's important to know those things. The system will alert you when tire pressure drops on any tire or if the heat goes up on any tire. These warnings should prevent a tire from blowing out. When you get a warning that the pressure is decreasing or the temperature is going up, you know that there's a problem and you can find a place to safely pull over to deal with the situation. And that leads me to the next part of this, and that is you need to have a plan in place for if you do have a tire blowout. Now that can mean having roadside assistance, or what I would prefer is to be able to fix it myself. And if fixing it yourself, you need to have the right equipment. You want to have a spare tire on a rim. You want to have a jack sturdy enough to lift up one side of your trailer. We have a ProLift hydraulic bottle jack that's 8 tons, which is plenty to lift up the trailer. You also need a tire iron with the right size head on it. A tire plug kit comes in very handy. If you have a nail or a screw or something like that in your tire, you can take out the item and plug it. An air compressor to blow up the tire. We have a Cat 3-in-1 professional power station with jump starter and air compressor. It's also handy as a battery pack to charge up your electronic devices. When you are fixing a flat tire, try to do it in a safe location, wear a safety vest, and if needed, put out some safety cones so that people can see you. The next thing is a weight distribution hitch. It is essential for most RVs. Our truck is rated to tow 10,800 pounds, but that means with a weight distribution hitch. Without a weight distribution hitch, it's only rated to tow 5,000 pounds. You can find this out checking the towing guides for your truck. They're all posted online for every make and model of truck. Without a weight distribution hitch, there will be a lot of weight on the back end of the truck, and it will get lowered. The front end of the truck will be raised up. In a situation like this, you're losing steering capabilities and braking capabilities, which leads to dangerous driving conditions. With a weight distribution hitch, it levels that off so that the front and back of your truck are at the same level. We have a Blue Ox Sway Pro weight distribution hitch rated for a tongue weight of 1,000 pounds. You need to check your truck and trailer specs, and I would suggest to consult with a professional to determine what weight distribution hitch is necessary for you. The next thing is towing mirrors. Towing mirrors stick out further than the regular mirrors. Now, some trucks come with extendable mirrors. This truck does not. We have a SEPA USA 11550 tow mirrors. They're an aftermarket mirror that just slip on over top of the original mirrors.
And now we're going to talk about safety at the campsite. Item number one, surge protector. A good surge protector will protect your RV electronics from electrical surges and also low voltage. And you never know from park to park the quality of the electricity you're getting to your site. The surge protector we have is a Camco 30 amp circuit analyzer with surge protection. In the future, we will probably be upgrading to an EMS, which is an electronics management system. It's a higher level of electronics protection. Now on to the next thing, fire extinguisher. Every RV should have a minimum of one fire extinguisher. And as well, you should have easily accessible water near your campsite to put out a fire when needed. Wheel chocks. As soon as you get to your site, before you unhitch from your vehicle, put the wheel chocks under your tires. We have Camco wheel chocks. Next on the list, water hose. You're gonna want a decent drinking water hose and plenty of it. Out there, there's the green or black hoses, which are typically used for gardening, but they're made of chemicals, which you don't want to have in your system. So you're gonna want, typically in the RV world, is a white drinking hose. And you want it to say specifically that it's for drinking water. We have the Camco 50-foot freshwater drinking hose. Probably down the road, we will upgrade to a 0G 50-foot hose just for the fact that it doesn't kink up like the white hose does and it takes up less space when you put it away. Next on the list, you're gonna want a water filter. Provincial parks are pretty good for purifying water, but if you're going out state parks, national parks, you don't know the quality of the water, so you would like to have some protection with a water filter. We have Camco 443-X Taste Pure RV Water Filter with Flexible Hose Protector. Even if you don't plan on drinking the water, it's good to have the water in your system clean at all times. Next on the list, we have a water pressure regulator. Each park is different. You don't know how much pressure is coming from the water tap to your trailer. And the water pressure regulator helps control the flow of the water so it doesn't upset your plumbing system in your trailer. And on a side note, another thing would be to turn off your water pump if you're leaving for the day, such as going to the beach or going into town. You never know, you don't want to have a pipe burst and have water cause major damage to your trailer. So if you remember, sometimes we forget this as well, but try and remember to turn your water pump off. Another very important thing that we all love to talk about is your sewer hose, or as everyone likes to call it, the stinky slinky. We have the Camco RV Easy Slip Sewer Kit. Please do not forget disposable gloves and hand sanitizer or wipes when you are emptying your sewer system. We don't want anybody getting sick. And thing to have with your stinky slinky is a 5-inch clear sewer hose adapter. And with this cool gadget, you hook up to your sewer, you open the black tank and let it pour out. You can see all the goods coming out. Once you start flushing with your black water flush, you can see all the gunk come out, and once the water is clear, then you know it's done its job.
This next thing isn't a gadget or something that you need to have, and there is a fair bit of controversy over it. But I recommend always turning off your propane when traveling. If you pull into a gas station and your fridge decides to ignite at that moment, you then have an actual flame right near the gas pumps. Very dangerous situation. If you were to be in an accident and a propane line broke, it would be spewing propane all over the place. Again, another very dangerous situation. In many provinces and states, it's required that you have your propane cistern turned off when going through tunnels. A lot of people like to keep their propane system on so they can keep their fridge cool. Well, your fridge is like a cooler. It will maintain the temperature for 7-8 hours while you're traveling down the road, so you don't have to worry about that. Please turn your propane off when traveling.
And that was the list of our safety essentials. We know that's not everything. I'm sure you all have different items that you could add to the list. Let us know below what you think. And we hope this was helpful.
And we'll see you in the next video.
Bye.
Bye.